Hey friends, my name is Sahil and this is my Personal Finance Academy. Of late, there's a lot of action in IRCTC shares. Its share jumped almost 300% in the last 6 months between April and October. It was trading at levels of 1600 in April and crossed the level of 6000 recently. So, although IRCTC is in the train business, the stock went up like a rocket. However, last two trading sessions have been dreadful for IRCTC investors. The share fell down at more speed than it went up. In the last two trading sessions, IRCTC share has tanked 30%. This two-day market crash has created a huge panic in the market. Although, today, at the time of creating this video, IRCTC has jumped 2%. So I have been getting a lot of queries from people asking about IRCTC. Should they sell the share or accumulate more on dips? Now, before we even look into buying or selling, let us first try to understand the reason behind the stock rise and the sharp fall. So in this video, we'll first discuss the five factors that resulted in almost 300% jump in IRCTC shares in just 6 months, and one factor that resulted in crash of 30% in just two sessions. Then we will discuss what should be the right approach for investors. By the way, on multiple requests, I have extended the 5 days Money Management Masterclass admission window till Saturday, that is 23rd October. So if you have not enrolled, then the enrollments are open till Saturday. So there were five factors that were driving the unstoppable growth in IRCTC share price. First factor is its monopoly business. IRCTC is the only company with 100% monopoly in the business it operates. It is the only company authorized for online ticket booking for Indian Railways and the only company authorized for catering service in the entire railway network of our country. Apart from this, it is the only company allowed to sell bottled water in the entire railway network. Now, it is not just about monopoly. It is also about the size of the market IRCTC address. Or in other words, the TAM, that is total addressable market. The total market size IRCTC address is huge. Indian Railway is one of the largest railway networks in the world. And within that, IRCTC is the only player with monopoly. On top of that, IRCTC has a highly profitable business. It is a completely debt-free company and has got high growth potential. Second factor is 100% rise in ticket booking in Q2. Last year was terrible for IRCTC due to lockdown in the country and it badly impacted its business. However, now the economy is opening up and there is already a 100% jump in online ticket booking for Q2 of FY22. Due to this, there is high expectation of good quarterly results from IRCTC. This is again driving the rally in the market. Third factor is IRCTC is becoming a complete hospitality solution provider. IRCTC is aggressively foraying into its hospitality business. It is making fresh tie-ups with hotels, tour and travel service provider and local food suppliers. IRCTC is also giving special focus to its food chain business in running trains. Apart from this, IRCTC has made tie-ups with aviation companies as well. Now it provides both domestic and international packages. So market has realized that in coming times, it is no more going to remain an Indian Railway e-ticket booking platform. It will emerge as an A to Z hospitality service provider. And considering the fact that more and more people now prefer to travel, this would boost the business of the company. And this business is only going to increase in the future. Fourth factor is due to stock split news. IRCTC has announced that it is going to split its stock price in 1:5 by 28th October. Now, due to that, there would be an increase in trading volume as a lot of small investors are willing to invest in IRCTC but not able to invest due to its high price. So it is expected that due to the stock split, there would be a jump in demand. Hence, there was high demand for IRCTC share before the split. Fifth factor is FOMO. Now we all understand that IRCTC is a monopoly business and is highly profitable and has got high growth potential. However, will that justify that 300% jump in share price? No. So the major reason that is driving the rally in IRCTC share is FOMO, that is fear of missing out. Every person wants to become a part owner in this company. So there's a fear that if they don't invest today, they will miss the rally. Due to that, in spite of trading at 4,000 and 5,000 level, there was demand for IRCTC shares. Hence, due to all these five factors, IRCTC share has seen a crazy jump in its share price. In fact, this FOMO is the major reason for many stocks trading at very high valuation. For example, IEX is trading at a PE of more than 100. Dixon Technology is trading at a PE of 175. Jubilant Foodwork is trading at a PE of 125. Titan is trading at a PE of 167. GMM Pfaudler is trading at a PE of 125. DMart, that is Avenue Supermart, is trading at a PE of 216. Yes, I agree that some of these companies have very high PE due to that sharp fall in earnings during COVID. And now that the economy is opening up, eventually the earnings would improve and that will reduce the PE. However, even after considering the earning improvement, these companies are trading at an ultra-high valuation. There is no doubt about the fact that all these companies are fundamentally strong and have a bright growth prospect. But due to FOMO, investors are buying these stocks at any level, and hence these stocks are trading at crazy levels. Now let's discuss what was that one factor that resulted in a sharp fall of 30% in share price of IRCTC. It is very simple. In the last 6 months, IRCTC saw a sharp rise in its share price due to retail investors investing even at crazy levels due to FOMO, that is fear of missing out. However, its earnings were not at par. The major reason was due to lockdown. The share price was increasing with the hope that eventually the earnings would improve. However, due to this expectation and earning improvement, IRCTC share jumped to an extent that it touched a PE level of 344. If you don't know how to calculate the PE, it is simply calculated by dividing the share price with earning per share. IRCTC share touched a price of 6,396 and its last 12 month EPS, that is earning per share, stood at 18.57. So PE is calculated as 6,396 divided by 18.57, which came out to be 344. That was grossly overvalued state. Now we all know that the earnings of IRCTC were badly hit by COVID. And now that the economy is opening up, its earning would eventually improve. Hence, if we neglect FY21 earning and consider FY20 earning, then in FY20, it earned a profit of Rs. 513 crore, which was 32.07 in terms of EPS. So if you look at the PE ratio by FY20 earning, it stood at 200. So in spite of neglecting FY21 earning due to lockdown and considering the normal scenario of FY20 earning, the valuation, that is PE, was highly overvalued. Even if you look at the forward earning of FY22, the valuations were on higher side. So basically the share price reached a level where it became extremely overvalued and hence it got corrected. Although the correction was too steep to digest. So the reason for 30% correction in last two sessions was because IRCTC was temporarily banned under the FNO segment by NSC. FNO is future and option, which is a derivative market. The reason for FNO ban was because IRCTC has crossed 95% market-wide position limit. Market-wide position limit is set by stock exchanges, which is the maximum number of contracts that can be opened at any time. If a stock crosses 95% market-wide position limit, NSC is mandated to put a temporary ban till the position in the contract comes below 80%. So for speculators who have been taking long positions, FNO ban is a bad news, as they will end up giving up a lot of their paper profit because traders will only be allowed to liquidate existing position and not take new position. And due to that, there was a steep fall of 30% in IRCTC share price. Now the question is that IRCTC share has corrected 30% in last two sessions. Should you sell IRCTC stock or hold or accumulate more? So the answer is simple. As far as fundamentals are concerned, there is no change in fundamentals. IRCTC has a bright growth prospect and it will continue to do well in the future from the business point of view. And as I mentioned before, the online booking business has seen strong growth in Q2 of FY22 due to ease of travel restriction. On top of that, the festival season would again contribute to the overall growth in revenue and profit. Now from the current levels, the share can still correct more due to high valuation. But if you are a long-term investor like me, then you don't need to panic. Don't worry too much about the share price movement. Ups and downs are part of the game. In fact, that is the best part of investing in fundamentally strong companies. I always invest in fundamentally strong companies, and when I invest with conviction. I don't just look at 2-3 months share price movement and decide if I should sell the share or not. In fact, whenever I invest my money and the share price fall, my worry is not to exit, but I only get confused in terms of should I accumulate more or should I wait for the more price correction. I generally don't think of selling the shares as I invest for long-term wealth creation. So I am holding IRCTC for long-term wealth creation. As far as accumulation is concerned, IRCTC is still overvalued. So I would suggest just waiting for things to normalize. When the stock is in downward trend, there is negative sentiment around it. So if the share falls further and reaches a state where the valuation looks comfortable, then you can consider accumulating more. But as far as selling is concerned, if you are a long-term investor, then I would suggest holding this share for long-term. I would again repeat that ups and downs are part of share market. If you want to create wealth, you need to keep patience and invest for long-term. If the share price fall bother you too much, then I would strongly suggest don't look at your portfolio 5 to 10 times a day. Frequently looking at your portfolio is not going to generate more returns. It is only going to create more greed and more fear. So in this video, we discussed the 5 factors that resulted in the rally of IRCTC share price and one factor that resulted in 30% fall in 2 sessions. And what should be the strategy for long-term investment? Now tell me in the comments if you are buying, selling or holding IRCTC shares. I also have provided my course link in the description. I hope you'll find this video useful. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care.